Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to this episode of What's in the Box, brought to you by the Battlegrounds Games and Comics. Today we're going to be opening a sealed booster box of Magic 2014 Core Set. This set had some pretty cool stuff in it. You've got Archangel of Thune at $23, Mutavault at $11, Colonian Hydra, Rise of the Dark Realms, Darksteel Forge at $8, Garrett, Collar of Beasts, Jace, Memory 8-Up at $6, and Johnny, Collar of Pride, Door of Destinies at $5. A slew of cards from $4 to $2. Primeval Bounty, Gone, Gale Rider, Sliver, Scavenging Ooze, Stryonic Resonator, Scourge of Valkus, Sanguine Blood, Chandra Pyro, Mancer, I can't remember which one it is, Ring of Three Wishes, Siphon Sliver, Fiend Slayer Paladin, Traumatize, and Bone Slice Sliver. I'm sure there's some commons and uncommons we will open in here as well that'll add a little extra value. But hopefully, if we're lucky, we knock out the Archangel thing for sure. And, you know, hey, snag that foil Mutavault and at least hopefully get a regular Mutavault. So let's get into this guy. And I've zoomed in a bit this time on the camera just so you can really see the cards we're opening. I'm going to take this booster box off to the side. But I do want you to, every box I want you to see is open, so you know that we're not trying to pull one over on you. So let's get started. As always, I'm just going to go ahead and flip to the uncommons. Don't want to waste time on commons. There's very little value over there. Okay, Briar Pack Alpha, Bramble Crush, Battle Sliver, first rare, Savage Summonings. I get used to this camera being zoomed in here. It's a little bit closer than what I'm used to, so make sure I get everything on the camera for you. I don't know if that lighting's better. Hard to say. They say lighting is really good for cameras, but it seems like it kind of fades everything out. Okay, let's jump forward here. All right, with our uncommons, we have Sarah Angel, another Bramble Crush, Enlarge, Ogle Battle Driver. Staff of Death Magus, Vampire Warlord, Staff of Vine Magus, Burning Earth. That was a popular card when it first came out. Seen a lot of play. Staff of Wild Magus, a Quarter Shield, a Doomblade, and a Tidebinder Mage. Hey, that's one that we forgot about. This card's all over the place, goes up and down, can't make its mind up how much it wants to be worth, but that's a good one. Sees a lot of play in Legacy and I guess Modern Merfolk. Okay. Glimpse of the Future, Volcanic Geyser, Staff of Sun Magus, and there's our first Mythic, Chandra Pyromaster. Of course, the cheapest of the mythics we came across, which is pretty crazy considering she is a planeswalker. At one point, she was seeing play in Modern, so I'm surprised that she has fell so much. Wall of Swords, Volcanic Geyser. And there's a good uncommon, Young Pyromancer. And Guardian of the Ages. Let's just go ahead and set our good mythics off to the side as well as our good uncommons. All the stores that you see open here you can find on our website at www.thebattlegroundsgames.com. We do We are one of the largest TCG Play dealers in the United States. Every little bit of business that you guys give us is appreciated a long way. We greatly appreciate our customers and everything they've done for us over the years. Encroaching Waste, Stonehorn Enchanter, Staff of Sun Magus, Second Mythic, a Johnny, Collar of the Pride, and a Foil Soul Mender. If you're ever in North Georgia, we do host a weekly event schedule that we'd love to have you attend if you can ever make it out. I do think we're probably the only one of, I've never seen another, but probably the only Magic store that has the mana symbols in our carpet. So that's kind of what we're known for. Magic is a big deal at the Battlegrounds games. Wall of Swords, Rod of Ruin, Barrage of Expendables, Bone Scythe Sliver. Okay, right to it. Gelrider Sliver, that was on the list. We were looking for him. That's a good one. And a Foil Hunt of the Week. Where are our foils? Let's go here. Put you guys up here. Dalwalk Tutor, Howl of the Night, and Millstone are our uncommons. We have a lot in store for this YouTube channel. Have a lot of things we're going to be adding. A lot more than just us opening product. We want you to get to know our employees and a little bit about what we do on a daily basis around the shop. So we have a lot to look forward to in the coming months with our YouTube channel. So we appreciate you watching. Voracious Worm, Air Servant, Stonehorn Chanter, Traumatize. I believe that was on the list as well of things we wanted to see out of this box. So far things are looking fairly promising. Opportunity, Air Servant, Dalwalk Tutor, Indestructibility. Okay, let's see what we got here. Spell Blast, Dark Steel Ingot, Dragon Egg, Shivan Dragon. Oh, there was a Tom. When nothing could have beat that. But how far have we came to our Shivan Dragon is nothing but starter deck rare fodder. Give me a Tinder Wall and some Orcish Lumberjacks and let's go to town with that Shivan Dragon. Alright, Sarah Angel, Flames of the Firebrand, Vial of Poison, Domestication, and a Foil Gnawing Zombie. So, M14 here is still an affordable box. Most places you can get it at or below its MSRP. The way Magic boxes are just going up in value, it's always worth to invest into some of these older sets while you still can get in on the cheap. So we're going to try to start bringing you as much content of us opening old product as we can. As we get more subscribers, we'll start delving into some of the more lucrative sets. Staff of the Wild Magus, Bubbling Cauldron, Congregate, and a Vastwood Hydra. What I've learned in the business over years, anything with the name Hydra in it usually is worth at least $1. So Gnawing Zombie, Shiv's Embrace, Artificer's Hex, and a Siphon Sliver that was on the list as well as a Foil Elvish Mystic. I'm pretty sure that's at least a couple bucks. Slivers, Hydras, used to be Dragons, I don't know if those are really anymore. Some dragons still bring premium, but not as much as they used to. Millstone, Corrupt, Artificer's Hex, Door of Destinies. This was also on the list. This is a big commander card, very popular. If you're into commander, check that card out. You will probably want one. I'm just going to move our uncommons here out of the way. That way we can kind of double dip here on our rares. So you keep those in the picture here. Move all this down. Zoomed in too much, I think. But the getting the camera's focus is the hard part. Okay, so we've got an academy. Let's see. Illusionary Armor, Fire Shrieker, Cinder Vampire, Planar Cleansing, and a Foil Mountain. There's another card. Rewind time a little bit and that Cinder Vampire. We're happy about that. Okay, Molten Birth, Bubbling Cauldron, Enlarge, Xanthrid Necromancer, and there's our foil rare, Savage Summonings. So nothing too great in the foil rare department. You know, we really want to open up good stuff for you guys so you can get as excited as we do when we open it. And just can't get lucky. Just nothing too exciting. Every now and then you get two rares in this box that are foils, so potentially there's still hope. Molten Burrs, Colonian Tusker, Battle Sliver, Dismiss into Dream. I don't think anyone's looking for that one. Alright. Encroaching Waste, Warden of Evos Isle, Congregate, and hey, there's a good one. Heard of that card before. If we can get the camera to focus. Mutavault. This is a very played Legacy Modern card. It was played in practically every Standard deck when it was in Standard. Not upset about that guy. Again, you know, more reason to buy this set. There are things that you use that are fairly uncommon that are in the rare slot in this box, in this set. Darksteel Ingot, Steelform Sliver, Angelic Accord, Garruk's Horde. We got one third of the box left to go. We've got a Shiv's Embrace, Mana Weft Sliver, Angelic Accord, and a Grim Return. I think the Mana Weft Sliver is still worth about a dollar. Mana producing sliver, can't go wrong there. Commanders just really help the prices on a lot of these cards that would be worth practically nothing now, as Commander keeps those prices up there. Woodborne Behemoth, Tenacious Dead, Brave the Elements, Elite Arcanist. Still hoping for that Archangel of Thune to make an appearance. That is the money card out of this set to get. Banisher Priest, Warden of Evos Isle, Flesh Pulper Giant, and a Quicken. Gotta be. It's probably two more mythics left in this box, so let's see what they are. Voracious Worm, Gnawing Zombie, Doomblade. There's one of them. Shadowborn Demon. Combos real well with these cards called Shadowborn Apostle. If you don't know that combo, check it out. It's a common. This guy right here. A deck can have any number of cards named Shadowborn Apostle. Sacrifice 6 creatures named Shadowborn Apostle. Search your deck for a demon creature card and put that card onto the battlefield. So Shadowborn Demon fits the demon protocol needed. A Rod of Ruin, Glimpse of Future, Dragon Egg, Pyromancer's Gauntlet, and there's our second foil rare, Haunted Plate Mail. Blightcaster, Howl the Night Pack, Vial of Poison, Lifebane Zombie. I'm going to go ahead and push these up so we can stay in our camera. Clonian Tusker, Wall of Frost, Flesh Pulper Giant, and a Ring of Three Wishes. So there's our first real dud mythic. Hopefully there's one more floating around in this box. Really like to see the Archangel of Thune, as she was probably the most sought after mythic in the set at the time in Standard. She's still going to be the most sought after now. Tenacious Dead, Staff of the Flame Magus, Wall of Frost, Bog Brew Witch. Quarter Shield, Blightcaster, Blessing, and a Ratchet Bomb. So, pretty good card. Not very valuable, but playable. Gets rid of those pesky tokens very easily. Vampire Warlord, Staff of the Flame Magus, Water Servant, Ajani's Chosen. We're down to 5 packs left. Fire Shrieker, Woodborn Behemoth, another young Pyromancer, a Chandra's Phoenix. Banisher Priest, Shimmering Grotto, Windstorm, Haunted Plate Mail, and a Foil Volcanic Geyser. Alright, we got 3 left. Glimpse the Future, Windstorm, Blessing, Path of Bravery. Staff of the Death Magus, Briar Pack Alpha, Barrage of Expendables, Jace's Mindseeker, and a Foil Cancel. This is it, last pack. Let's hope for a mythic. Spell Blast, Phantom Warrior, Elixir of Immortality, and a Scavenging Ooze. At least we finished with one of the best green creatures ever made. We will take him. Alright guys, so that'll do it for this box of Magic Core Set 2014. Be sure to check out all of our other videos, as we've got quite a few posted now of us opening some sweet, sweet product, depending on if you're just into Magic, Pokemon, Yu-Gi-Oh, whatever you're into. We are trying to cover every trading card game. We will soon have the release of Final Fantasy Opus 2, where we will be opening some of that. I was going to bring you guys some HeroClix, Deadpool, and the X-Force, but WizKids went and screwed up the distribution on it, so it was not a lot of fun to watch, because it was all the same thing. Every booster pack we opened looked out of a case, looked just like the next one in a case. So we scratched that video, didn't really see much good in showing you a video of us opening a bunch of the same thing. So anyways, thanks for tuning in. Please like and subscribe. Again, if you're ever in the North Georgia area, come see us. We'd love to get to know our viewers and introduce us to you. So anyways, this is Michael from the Battlegrounds Games, and thanks for watching. Again, be sure to like and subscribe.
to